Let us all stand. Amen. Amen. Father, we thank you this morning. We praise you. Glory to God. Lord, we exalt your name because you're God. You're our Lord. You're our King. You're the creator of all things, oh God. And so, God, we come boldly before the throne of grace. God, you told us in the word, God, that we will find help in the time of need. And so, God, we thank you for being God in our lives, oh God. We exalt you, God, because you're our Lord. You're our Savior. And we thank you for being God in our life. And so, God, we ask God now that you would have your way today in this race, oh God. Hallelujah. We look unto the hills from which cometh our help. Blood of Jesus. God, we plead the blood. We plead the blood over every disease, oh God. Over every virus, God. We thank you now, God. In the name of Jesus, we are healed by the blood of Jesus. You said in your word, God, when I see the blood, I pass over you. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, oh God. We give you glory today. We thank you now. Encourage your people everywhere, God. Let them know that you got this. Let them know, God, that all power is in your hands. Have your way today.
Yeah. great things for me. Great things for me.
comes to mind in this house right now. Hallelujah, in spite of it all. Every time I turn around, the Lord keeps right on. Somebody help me say right on. Somebody help me say right on. Every time I turn around. He keeps on. Doing great things for me. Hallelujah. 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 Gracious Father God in heaven, we come now, oh God, just to say thank you, God. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your grace, God. Father, in spite of it all, God, Father, we see the goodness. We see your glory, God. Thank you right now, Jesus, for how you're touching, for how you're healing, for how you're delivering, how you set captive men and women free. We decree it and we declare it in this house today, healing today. If there be any sick amongst us, touch them right now, God. Send your word today, God. I pray now, God. I pray right now, God, that some soul be saved. That some man, woman, boy, or girl, oh God, would change their way of walking, oh God, and turn to you today, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray, Father, that you anoint my lips today as I stand before your people today, that you will allow me to speak as an oracle of you today, God. I dare take not any glory, God, for what you're getting ready to do, oh God, in this house, God, throughout the airways, oh God. Father, in the name of Jesus, touch right now, God. Set captive men and women free, God. Heal broken heart. Touch confused mind. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. This is our prayer that we pray. And all of God's people are putting their hands together and giving him praise. Come on, put those hands together and give God some praise. All over this building, come on. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Come on, bless his name. Come on, you don't have to stop giving God some praise. He's in the room right now. He's in your living room right now. He's in your automobile right now. He's in the workplace, wherever you are. I dare you to welcome the presence of the Lord. Jesus. Somebody say it soothes all of my doubt. It calms all of my fear. Just the name of Jesus. Demons tremble and they got to flee. Anybody want to call on the name? Anybody calling on his name today? Help me say Jesus. Help me say Jesus. While you're standing, amen, grab your Bibles, it's word time. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. family is gathered together. I hope you have your Bibles. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If you would turn with me, amen, to 2 Chronicles. 2 Chronicles chapter 14. Verses 9 through 13. Amen. We just thank God for assisting pastor, to all the men of the clergy, to all of you that have made your way out today. You look good to me today. It's good, amen, to see some faces. Amen. Some spirit-filled men and women of God. Amen. After we've gone, amen, all week long, to the workplace, amen. Or if you had to go, amen, you just may be there in your home. Amen. It's just good to be in the presence of God where His Spirit is flowing. Thank you, Jesus. 2 Chronicles, amen, the 14th chapter, the 9th verse, amen, and it reads, it says, there came out against them Zephah, the Ethiopian, amen, with a host of 1,000,000 and 300 chariots, and came unto Moab. Then Asa went out against him. They set the battle in array in the valley of Zephra at Maisha. And Asa cried unto the Lord his God, and said, Lord, it is nothing with thee to help, whether with many or with them that have no power. Help us, O Lord, our God, for we rest on thee. And in thy name we go against this multitude. O Lord, thou art our God. Let not man prevail against thee. So the Lord smote the Ethiopian before Asa and before Judah, and the Ethiopian fled. And that final verse, and Asa and the people that were with him pursued them unto Gur. And the Ethiopian were overthrown that they could not recover themselves, for they were destroyed before the Lord and before his host, and they carried away very much spoils. And God's word is blessed. God bless you. You may be seated in his presence on day. Thank you, Jesus. Just another day that the Lord has kept us. Amen. If there ever was a time that we need an encouraging word, how many of you know now is the time? I don't know, amen, about you, but I come to be fed this morning myself. Amen. I need to be encouraged through the word of God on this morning. Amen. You can't turn the TV on, amen, without hearing about the coronavirus or COVID-19, however you label it. Amen. It has bombarded the media. Amen. And sometime, amen, if you go, amen, and you're looking at this all day, amen, this will get in your spirit, amen, and you won't want to do nothing else. Amen. But be shut up wherever you are. But I come to speak life to somebody today. I come to speak a word, amen, and on the behalf to the believers, amen, today. Wherever you are, there is a word from the Lord on today. Amen, amen. And the word of the Lord comes to us today. Amen. I don't want you to touch somebody. Amen. I'm not going to ask you to touch your neighbor. Amen. Or shake your neighbor's hand. Amen. I understand. We're exercising something today. Amen. Social distance, amen, or however you label it. Amen. But I do want to speak something. Amen. You can look at a neighbor. Amen. And just tell a neighbor,
neighbor,
I am not
afraid.
Afraid. Come on, look at somebody and tell them, neighbor,
neighbor
or neighbor,
neighbor,
I am not afraid. Amen. And here's the reason why I want you to know, amen, today, why I'm not afraid. Amen. Because I am under divine protection. Did y'all hear what I said today? Why it is that I'm not afraid? Because I am under divine protection. Somebody ought to clap your hands right there and give God some praise. When demonic forces come, amen, and they sense fear, they gain confidence, believing, amen, that the battle is won even before it begins. Even a dog or a wild animal likewise gains strength, amen, amen, and boldness, amen, and confidence, amen, when they smell fear. Amen. It prepares them to go in for the attack. Yes. Believers are in a fight for their life. Yes. But it is not, amen, with one another. Paul says it like this, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, yes, amen, but against principalities, yes, against powers, yes, against the rulers of darkness, yes, amen, of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. The same devil, amen, that dislike you, amen, I want to share with you today, he dislikes me. The same devil that hates, amen, me, he hates you. For he's the same devil, amen, that wants to destroy, amen, me and you. I said he is the same devil. And that's why it's good for us to remind, amen, amen, to be reminded from time to time, amen, that we as children of God are on the same team. No need to fight one another, bickering with one another. We on the same team. Amen. Tell somebody, same team. We're not getting anywhere, amen, when we fight one another. We're not getting anywhere by being upset with one another, amen, but we should stand together to fight the common enemy, which is the devil. Have mercy, Lord. Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, is one of God's guys, good guys. It's so uplifting, amen. It's so, amen, encouraging to know that there are still some good guys, amen, left. But even good guys face hard times. Even good guys must deal with, amen, not so good situations. Jehoshaphat is faced with a problem that would not go away. There will always be some problems, my brothers and sisters, that we cannot sweep under the rug. There will always be some problems that we cannot ignore, if you please. And as quiet as it is kept, some today, even in this house, in the obedience laws, have certain fears about certain things now. Can I talk to you today? Some are depressed. Some are oppressed. Some are caught up, amen, in some things, amen, such as witchcraft. Some are dibbling and dabbling in the occult, if you please. Amen. And then there are some that just plain scared. And then there are some that are fearful that their dirty little secret just might get out. But if you are a child of God, you must face your fears with confidence. Somebody shout confidence. Ah, thank you, Jesus. Because the word fear, amen, when we break it down, amen, in the acronym form, amen, fear, amen, is only false evidence appearing real. That's what fear is, y'all. I said false evidence appearing real. Now, you got to keep in mind, if you truly walk with God, that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of a sound mind. Now, I'm convinced that the devil cannot have my mind. I'm convinced of that. He cannot have my soul. Neither can he have my body. He cannot have my mind, body, and soul, because all I have, somebody sung the song, everything that I have, it belongs to God. As a son of Asa, Jehoshaphat was able to be under a covering of righteousness. Asa was a good man. That which he did was right, amen, and acceptable in the sight of God. He took away the altars of the strange gods, small g. Amen. He took away, amen, the high places, amen, the elevated places of idol worshipers. He breaks the image, amen, or, amen, of sacrifice pillars, amen, and amen, and he cuts down the bronze or the wooden images, if you please.
Yes.
So Jehoshaphat had a very good example before him.
Yes.
Amen. And in his DNA
was
a do-right spirit. Somebody say a do-right spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Well, we might as well, amen, be honest, amen, amen. Not everyone has a do-right spirit. Please don't look at anybody, amen. Wherever you are, amen, don't look to the left or to the right, but stay focused straight ahead. Some folks can't wait, amen, to do wrong. Some even come to church, amen, with you with a wrong spirit instead of a do-right spirit. But a person who has a do-right spirit will always go further and have less headaches than those who purposely do wrong. Y'all gonna pray for me this morning? I'm almost there. And cause others unnecessary mischief and grief. Talking about a person with a do wrong spirit. Three enemy nations now have come against Jehoshaphat to battle. The children of Moab and the children of Ammon and the inhabitants of Mount Seir.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. The Bible says that Jehoshaphat feared and he set himself to seek the Lord and proclaimed a fast. This is what the king, amen, a fear that made him do something positive. This was the king, amen, a fear that got him, amen, and said, I need God's help. Oh my God. This was not the king of fear, amen, that strapped him down, amen, and caused him to hide behind closed doors of fear. Amen. This was not the kind of, amen, of fear that caused him to shut up, amen, and to shake, amen, like a leaf on a tree. Amen. But this was the kind of fear, amen, that said, God, if you don't help me out this time, then there may just not be a next time. Good God Almighty. Amen. And I think, amen, that all of us, amen, have to have that kind of fear, amen, to where, amen, we have said, amen, to God, God, if you don't help me now, don't know there's going to be anything left of me after a while. Anybody need the Lord's help right now? Anybody really know that you can't do it on your own? That you need God's help? Come on, clap your hand. Amen. If you really know that you need the help of the Lord. Yes, yes. And we've got to have that kind of reverence unto God. That kind of respect unto God. Amen. That kind of belief in God. Amen. That no matter what comes up against us, that God is able to sustain us. Come on, clap your hands and tell the Lord thank you. For the Bible says that Jehoshaphat feared, amen, and set himself to seek the Lord. And he proclaimed a fast. Good God Almighty. For Jesus said, when ye pray, believe and ye receive them, and ye shall have them. Good God Almighty. Amen. And all of us have to face the enemy forces. Good God Almighty. They may be enemy forces. Amen. They may not be the enemy forces of the children of Abraham. They may not be, amen, the children of Moab. They may not be the inhabitants of Mount Seir. But we face some things right about now. We face sickness. We face unpaid bills. We face uncertainties by losing our jobs. We face stress, trauma, and disease. Some of us are facing COVID-19. We face worrying about our children and our grandchildren. We face worrying about our businesses. We face unnecessary and unusual exceeding taxation. But what I want to leave with you is this one thing. And the thing, amen, that surrounds us, amen, that I need to tell you today, that when ye pray, believe and receive, and ye shall have them. Good God Almighty. I was reminded the other day when I grabbed my Bible because I needed some encouragement. Amen. And the Lord led me to the 91 number of a psalm. Can I read the book today? And there he said, amen, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadows of the Almighty. I will say unto the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him will I trust. Can I read on down, y'all? Surely he will deliver thee from the snares of the fowlers and from the noose of pestilence. He shall cover thee with the feathers of honor. His wing shall thou trust. In his truth shall be shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that fileth by day, nor the pestilence, amen, that walketh in darkness, nor the destruction that wasteth at noonday. Amen. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only, somebody help me say, only with thy eyes shall thou behold and to see the reward of the wicked. Because, somebody help me say, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, amen, in the Most High, amen, thy habitation. Thou shall no evil befall thee. Shall there any plague, somebody help me today, come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bind thee up in the hands, lest thou dash thy foot against the stone. They shall tread upon the lions. Good God Almighty. him up on high because he had known my name. He shall call upon me and I will answer. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him. Good God Almighty, honor him. With long life, somebody help me say, with long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Can I read the book? Good God Almighty. And then I had to turn. Good God Almighty. Over in Exodus, the 12th chapter, and that 13th verse. And it said, the blood shall be to you for a token upon the house where ye are. And when I see, good God Almighty, the blood, I'll pass over you and the plague. Somebody happy, shout the plague. Shall not be upon you to destroy you. Good God Almighty, when I spike the land of Egypt, I got three words for COVID-19. I got three words for the coronavirus. I wish I could get somebody to help me shout, the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. If you're coming out of the blood, you don't have to worry about a thing. I'm so glad. I'm so glad. I don't fear nothing. I'm so glad. I got the blood of Jesus. Thank God for reminding me, choir. Every now and then, when I hear you sing the song, what can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing. Somebody help me shout, nothing. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. I'm going in and I'm coming out. I'm going about my Father's business because I'm covered.
Flows because God is in control. A church where God is really real. Hi, my name is Dennis Rogers, pastor here at the Greater New Bible Word Church of God in Christ. I would like to welcome you to our services. Service times are Sunday morning prayer and Sunday school, 9 a.m. Sunday morning worship, 11 a.m. Sunday evening Pentecostal service, 7 p.m. Midweek service, Thursday,